lose everything. Need this? Maybe not. That should do it.
Marauders killing freaks, huh? Doing something right for a change.
Shit, I'm almost out.
Thank you.
Okay. Be useful. Fuel. Here we go. Good. Okay. Shit, what the hell happened here? Well, might be worth having a look around. Fix this. It should work. This man I'm tracking down. Big kill.
Why do you care? It's just another bounty job, isn't it?
Now look, I don't care. I just want to know their names. Who, Cope?
One of them is a man named Randall. Been with the camp almost a year. I didn't know the other two. You want me to ask?
No, I guess not.
You find that son of a bitch, you radio me. Copeland out.
You're mine now.
There he is! What the... Silver helmet. Red gas tank. That's it.
Oh, shit! The hell?
So you thought you'd ride into Copeland's camp, shoot the place up, that about right? Kill a few folks, take some shit, just ride out, and you just go shopping at the mall.
Copeland sent you? Tell him to go to hell!
On that. Not a fan of it myself, if you want to know the truth. Give drifters a bad name. What if you had shot Manny? You know, who'd fix my bike then? Stupid piece of shit.
Screw you! You are a Copeland's toadies! You little bitch! That's what you are! You little bitch!
Nope, it's done. Got him.
You tell
Marked on these coordinates and send your man out here.
You hear me?
Hey, easy.
Yeah, he's alive. But I won't promise you how long he's gonna stay that way. Deacon out. Boozer, you there? I was just calling to check up on you.
Yeah, D, come here.
You hang in there, buddy. As soon as we get that arm patched up, we'll ride north, just like you said.
I hope so. God, I miss you, brother.
You just work on getting better. I still got some work to do on the bike, and we gotta stock up on some gear. But once you're patched up, we're out of here. Beacon out.
by and say hello to Copeland. Much appreciated. Copeland out.
Deacon.
Sometimes, you know? Like, do they feel pain? Anything?
I didn't think I'd see you around so much.
Hey.
Should work. Looking for something in particular? What? Not enough credits? See ya.
Cope says you've been helping out around the camp. No saying, but he appreciates it.
What's up, Manny?
What, is something wrong? Wrap that up for you. Hey, man, I got a lot of shit to do. Look me up if you need anything else.
I was in my class.
See you, D.
When, you know, I taught English, Jamal through the college. Bunch of stay-at-home moms.
That's all I got.
Anyway, we heard all this screaming. Thought it was a shooting at first.
Hey. But hey, Deke. I heard you were thinking about heading north. Up to Smith Rock or some shit. Yeah, Boozer told me a few days back. Where the hell is he, anyways?
Look, I'm just here to turn in some. Yes, yeah, we're gonna be riding north. We just. It's time to move on.
Just listen, man. I'm ready to move on, too, you know? I'm like you. I grew up around here. Yeah, Cope's been good to me, but a lot of ghosts, you know? Look, you and Boozer head north. Take me with you.
Yeah, a lot of ghosts. Yeah, no. Let me think about it, okay? When we head north, I'll let you know.
Thanks, Deke. You're the best. Yep.
There's never enough wood on this fire.
All right, then. See ya.
Get out of the way.
Hey, how you doing?
Jazzy.
You believe it?
You died. This will kill a lot of people.
You, need something, man?
What's up, Manny?
Yep, always needing fuel. Drifter life. Thanks, man.
Hey, what's going on?
Something. It'll stand the test of time. And the same hands that built this country? They'll withstand anything this new world throws at us. Our roads bend, friends, but they do not break. And neither will we. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
They look pretty broken to me, Cope, but hey, whatever you say. And nothing wrong with a little crass and commercialism. I mean, I could use a new bike right about now. Okay, this is it. Yeah, oh, this camp is gonna be crawling. Yeah, going on foot, nice and quiet. Finally, Jesus. Oh, warehouse. Yeah, that looks like the kind of place you want to call home, yeah. Damn it, what you all shit yourself at once? Jesus Christ. Okay, gotta be careful, gotta be careful. All right. Fire in the hole. Get kind of cold out here. That's it. I'm just gonna grab some shot eye. That should do it. Thank you. That's all of them in here. More in here? Yep. Like that, huh? Come on, you sons of bitches, come on! Not about that blows that real good. Should be it. Oh, yeah, a nest. Okay, boys, just keep right on sleeping. Pay no attention to me. Mm. Come on, boys and girls. Let's do this.
Yeah, burn it up.
Is that the last of them? Boozer, it's done. I cleared those nests. Should be less freaks on the mountain from now on.
Hey, Deke. How'd it go? Were there a lot of them?
Yeah, but I wanted to clear them while it was still light out. You know how the sunlight bothers them.
Yeah, that's probably the way to do it. And anyway, well, thanks for doing that, Deke.
Get some shut-eye, Boozer. Deacon out. Raider camp. Bunch of mean sons of bitches, aren't you? How many ambushes you...
set this week, huh? I gotta clear the camp. Bunch of murderers and thieves, and I can't let any of them escape.
This'll do.
More. saw something.
Come on! Fuck! Keep moving!
That's it. Roads will be a little safer now. I mean, not much, but a little. All right, where did you hide your bunker, huh? I know you got one.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. It's the Wild West again. And some men are acting like law and order are a thing of the past. But last I checked, this is still the United States of America. And in America, the right of property shall not be infringed. We have the right to claim territory, to hold it, and to defend it. Sure, we took this land from the Indians. No point in rewriting history, but we took it by force. And force is the only thing that will move us now. We're not gonna roll over for a bunch of bullies. If the feds or rippers or marauders think they're gonna come rolling into my wilderness, they got another thing coming. The strongest survive, the strongest take, and the strongest will succeed. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's something, Cope. Law and order are a thing of the past. What are you talking about?
But yeah, you got a point about force being the only thing that matters now. Force and a lot of goddamn ammo.
Here's the hatch. Yeah, there you have one. Got here a map. Yes. Hey, what's this? Crafting. Yes, yes, yes. Good. another infestation zone. See what I can do. I never knew that. Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? What do we got? Maybe in one of these. Got it. I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to.
Rogers, man, are you listening? Oh, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper.
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper. It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. And don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid. Whoa, hold on, they're slowing down. It looks like they're stopping.
Jesus, this is taking forever.
I don't know. Forever's a long time.
Wonder how long this will take.
Too damn long. That's how long.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, it's O'Brien. Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
This will be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage 3.
Then what the hell happened, Sarah? No.
After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's... hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
They're sleeping like babies. Sarah.
And I asked if you were going with him. Can't say I was.
That ought to distract them.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Oh, shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
Then what the hell
is this, Sarah? Babies.
No, forget it.
And I asked if you were going with him. Didn't say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Can't see me in there.
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White Canyon.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like it was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was foobar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Sealed caves. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
How long do you think we got?
How the hell do I know? We'll bug out with Doc's first.
I really hate these assignments.
Yeah, I hear you. Let me guess. You'd rather get the belt out of games than eat even the breaker shit.
You hear that? That's right. Go check it out. Stay low, stay low.
Jesus, this is taking forever.
I don't know if forever's a long time.
Wasn't he
my turn on the duty roster.
Playing to the CO. Do I look like the CO?
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
What are the girl? The Nero guy, the soldier. Who took Sarah.
What are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. Wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait. You went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. About a man named O'Brien.
Pink, don't.
Not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just. Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out. Cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they'd have blown it to hell. Just so we wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit Radio Free Oregon.